right, welcome back to the Knives Fast channel, guys. We're going to jump right into this one and definitely stick around on the Knives Fast channel. This is a knife that was sent to me by Kansept, and this is designed by Ralph Helbig. And Ralph is a really cool designer. This is called the BTF Damascus and Brown Micarta 3.24 inch blade. Now, you might be thinking, what is BTF? Why is it called the BTF? And what I said was it was like a big tasty fish or a big tuna fish or big tomato fries. I don't know. Yeah, you know, I always think food. So, of course, I had to go and make it weird. But, no, it stands for Basic Tanto Folder. And Rolf says this one was designed after a Japanese quaken, which is a very old traditional fixed blade, and it is a tanto-style blade. And he says, quote, "I just turned it into a folder." Well, he did more than that. He made this really cool, and Kansept did some really nice touches. Now, in the case of this one, what you have here is you have brown micarta that has been made to look like bamboo, and I really think that's cool. One of the things I like the most, if you're gonna do a layered handle material, you want to have contouring. And what we have is we have contouring this way, but we also have these convex dips in here to make it look like, again, bamboo, which I think is really cool. But it gives you this incredible looking banding, very classy. Now, I gotta be honest, I wasn't positive I was gonna like this knife when I first saw it, especially with this guy up top. This is a thumb disc. And you know, thumb discs for a lot of people are a big no. For me, they've kind of been a, I'm not sure, because most of the time when I see a thumb disc, it doesn't work really well for me. I can't use it really well. We'll get to that in a minute. We have black liners here. Our blade comes out here close to the end, and we have a lovely crown spine done by Kansept there. It is a liner lock, and we have black hardware with a black wash, obviously, clip and screws and pivot. It is tooled on both sides like Kansept typically does, which means it's got race washers and ceramic cage ball bearings. You can see right off the bat, guys, this is where this guy shines. We have these great, what turns out to be a chamfer here in the handle that makes it really easy to just come right up under that thumb disc. Now, I can also do it with my middle finger, and I can easily middle finger flick this guy. The detent is dialed in on this guy, and it is really, really good. So I have maybe a few times kind of missed, because again, I would say, I always say on these thumb discs, I would like that jimping to be a little more aggressive. It's not bad, but if it was a little more aggressive, then I would never skid off. But if you just kind of follow this line right there and come up, it is easy as can be. So easy and beautiful. And we have this gorgeous Damascus here. We'll talk about the other variants it comes in a minute. But this one is Damascus, and you have a true tanto looking folder. Now, when it's open, we have a tiny bit of side-to-side here. Again, I haven't adjusted the pivot or done anything, so it might be as simple as it needs a pivot adjustment. There is no up and down. It is locked up very well at about a 35 to 40. Now, my nitpick on this one is there is no pass-through to the lock bar. You can see here, we are flat across here, and that's to keep the lines, I'm sure. Again, basic tanto folder, very basic, very neutral handle, very neutral blade, very basic. It fits down mostly inside the handle. There's a little bit sticking up, so I get why they wouldn't want to make a big dip here, but for use, I wish they would have just made that little cut to match the cut they made there. But if you just kind of take your thumb across there, we have a nice relief cut here, and it just moves out of the way really easy. Guys, I got to tell you, I carried this a few days ago, and I could not stop playing with it all day. The detent is perfect. You can see those bearings. It just drops. This thing is really good. So really, even though I'm nitpicking that I wish there was a pass-through, it's not really necessary, in my opinion. It doesn't need it. It would be a little more user-friendly, but it also works. You saw one of those little slips there, guys. Did you see that? Just a little one. Every once in a while, but not bad. But there you go. And man, does it ever drop. It is. And that's why I've been doing it like this, so I don't accidentally cut myself. Really cool. Now, guys, this sucker is a cutter. You can see here, boy, did I get, I got a double piece of cardboard here. That is crazy of me. That is really, really thick, but good. And we'll try that again, actually, because I bet now that I know what it is, it'll cut it just fine. So we're going to pull that back out and we're going to hit it one more time. I just wasn't prepared for it. Oh yeah, it cuts fine. Just wasn't prepared for that. I was like, oh, it's just going to skid right through. But no, of course not. Thicker, thicker stuff. So really cool knife. It cuts like nobody's business. We'll go over to specs here in a minute, but you can see fairly thin, and we do have a taper at that tanto. So we are flat ground here, flat ground here. You do have a secondary tip. And again, just a very elegant looking, simple looking folding knife. So there are 5 versions of this available. And you can go to the link I will put up below. There is this version with the Damascus for $98. There is a similar brown micarta version with a black blade for $98. And then there are 2 fat carbon versions. And I think it's the Chinese fat carbon. You have a green one and kind of a black and white one. Yep, yep, yep. And they actually call it white nebula. And what do they call that one? Grass green. And they are $129.89. And then there is a more budget-friendly one at $84.89 with G10, green G10, and S35. By the way, all of them are S35 except this Damascus one here. So if we go to the specs real quick, and while I'm doing that, I'm going to show you our normal comparisons here. So here is our friend, the Ontario Rat 1 and the Rat 2. You can see the Rat 1 is a little bit bigger, and the Rat 2 is about the same length, guys. Really, really interesting because it definitely feels good in the hand. 7.43 inches overall. You can see here, I get a very nice four finger grip, very neutral handle, and it feels really good with these dips. It just feels great. You can land right on that thumb disc, and again, really good, nice sharpening choil as well, good relief, no problems there with that. The blade thickness is 0.118 or 3 millimeters. Let's move these two guys off out of the way real quick. 0.118 or 3 millimeters, 3.24 ounces. And again, the blade length is 3.24 inches. How weird is that? And again, made in China by Kansept and designed by Rolf Helbig. Guys, what do you think of this one? It really grew on me. I didn't really talk about the clip. I should do that real quick. You know, it's not bad. You do feel it a little bit right there, but I would definitely not call it a hot spot at all. It does sit up on the scales. I would prefer it to be cut down in there. It is not reversible. There is no lanyard pin. And the only other thing I would say is I wish the clip was straight. I understand exactly why they didn't, because they couldn't really center it. It is close to centered, but I do wish that clip was kind of, whoa, what'd I just do? I moved it. That was neat. So how did I do that? That's interesting. I guess because it's sitting there. But definitely wish it was turned down just a little bit. It is definitely secure, so I don't even know how I did that. But anyway, so I stopped for a second to play with this clip a little bit more, guys, and I can't just ignore that. But yeah, I don't know. It feels like that front screw is moving a little bit, and that would explain why this guy is off center. It should be centered, and I've just thought that was a design thing. But no, I think that front screw is actually not completely secure and is moving. So definitely thought I would show you that. It would be interesting to know if they're all kind of like that, or if that's just, you know, I didn't think it was supposed to be crooked like that. So definitely thought I should mention that for sure. But overall, really interesting knife indeed. I would love to hear what you guys think. I know some of you have picked these up. Let me know what you think of it. And guys, leave me a comment down below. Like, make sure you're subscribed and hit that notification bell. And I appreciate all of you for everything you do for the channel. And thanks for watching the Knives Fast Channel.